Thank you. My friends, I cannot well express how glad I am to see you both unharmed. They say that Omega's clash with the Primal shook the very firmament.
You need not have worried. The battle took place far above the ground. We were able to observe in relative safety, though I'm given to understand that there were casualties on the far side of the wall.
It was like watching a nightmare unfold before our very eyes. Ilbird's primal manifested in the form of a colossal dragon, a being of pure violence. It burst forth from the cocoon with such terrible force.
That such a horror should spring from the eyes of Nidhogg comes as no surprise. Nor do I wonder at its form. Ilbird all but announced it in the moments prior to his death. Plainly, it was his dying wish to visit a second calamity upon the Empire.
And I am quite certain the abomination would have obliged had it not found itself outmatched by Omega. Gods! I am no stranger to the works of Alag, but even I was unprepared for the machine's furiosity. It beggared belief.
And how fares poor Ida in the midst of all this? Have you spoken with her?
She is up on the platform, lost in thought. We deemed it best not to disturb her, but mayhap she would welcome some company after all. Shall we?
The light's gone. It was all we had left of him.
Ida.
I don't blame anyone. I knew what was going to happen. I knew the spell Papalimo meant to cast would drain away his life force. I knew that it would only buy us a little time.
Ida, there is no need to explain.
But there is. I can't hide in Papalimo's little shadow anymore, and I shouldn't hide behind my sister's mask. 20 years ago, on the day the Empire marched into Alamigo, I was still just a child, not even 5 summers old. My father had been one of the leaders of the revolution. He had fought to overthrow the mad king, Theodoric. And my sister had fought alongside him. But she was strong and kind, and always knew what to do. But when the Garleans came, everything changed. My father went to war against them too. And I never saw him again. After that, I remember a lot of running. My sister dragged me for miles and miles until we came to the city of Charlion. That was where she met Master Louis Soir. He introduced her to the Circle of Knowing, and she eventually became an Archon.
She was your inspiration. Is that not why you took up her mask and her name? Or did you simply mean to continue what she had started?
Y-
You've known all along, haven't you? That I wasn't Ida.
Of course. We all recognized you at once. 'Twas Papalimo who persuaded us to maintain the charade.
It was silly to think I could fool you. I knew that even then, but I sort of decided not to know.
Ida died 6 years ago, on a mission to smuggle refugees out of Alamigo. They say she was overwhelmed by Imperial soldiers when she stayed behind to save a little girl. She was so strong. There must have been a lot of them.
I'm sorry for lying to you. My real name is Lys. When Papalimo brought me Ida's mask, it was meant as a keepsake, but I decided I wanted to be his new partner, to keep alive all the good that she had done. I didn't want to become Ida, exactly. At the time, though, I still didn't know who I was myself, and it almost seemed easier to play the role. Papalimo agreed to help, of course, but it was never what he wanted for me. He wanted me to walk my own path, and those were his final words to me. The Archon's mark he gave me is faded, and my last excuse along with it. So this is it. Whatever I choose to do from now on, I do as Lys. And I choose to continue my family's fight. I want Alamigo to be the country that Ida and my father always wanted it to be.
War is upon us once more.
Do you regret standing against the Empire? Would you have chosen a different road, knowing what you know now?
To claim that I never doubted the decision would be a lie. But I made my choice, and I have defended it with blade in hand ever since.
The battle continues! And our steel is needed. Come, Shadowwalker. We leave for the east, for Doma.
Children of the land, do you hear echoes of truths that once rang clear? Two souls intertwined. but flames that burn full bright soon fell dark. Memories dimmed by shadowed hearts in the waxing gloom did wane the lover's moon, watching as their worlds drift apart. One soul's cry, a passion welling within. Sacrifice, a vine of plea to her kin. Yet this bond of hope, my treachery was broke, scattering her words to the swelling over long seas of blood are a song, and death an afterthought to those who fight for not. Incomplete.
Question is, how will the Empire respond to the disappearance of Omega and the Primal? Oh, I didn't see you there. Forgive me. Word from Baelsar's wall is proving long in the coming, and my mind cannot help but stray to grim places.
Alphano, a message from the Alliance.
It's about time. Pray summon the others at once.
Yes, sir.
General Uldin reports that his forces have secured the breach in Baelsar's wall.
And what of the Primal and Omega?
There is still no sign of either at this time. He writes that they will begin a more thorough investigation shortly. And, as expected, he wishes to petition the aid of the Scions of the Seventh Dawn.
As expected.
The Alliance's decision to capture a part of Baelsar's wall is open to interpretation.
The wall serves to demarcate Imperial territory, Alamigo included, from the rest of Eorzea. To an observer, the Alliance's actions could be seen as a prelude to invasion.
Indeed. And the Alliance leaders have no wish to be branded invaders.
You're saying they won't fight for Alamigo? Even after everything that's happened?
Not without the consent of her people, no. Make no mistake, Lys. The Alliance is in complete agreement that the Empire must be purged from Eorzea. However, they will not set foot in Gir Abarnia until they have formally secured the consent and cooperation of the Alamegan opposition.
They would have us act as intermediaries.
Precisely. The Scions are uniquely qualified to serve in this capacity. That is to say, Lys's, given her personal connection to the Resistance. Who better than you to broker an agreement between the Alliance and the people of Alamigo? Assuming you are willing, of course.
Of course I am! You know I'd like nothing more!
As for who should accompany you on said diplomatic mission, I had a mind to volunteer myself.
Well, that covers the talking part. But you just know there'll be trouble along the way. Are you available? Thanks. It means a lot knowing you'll be there.
I too shall accompany you. Such endeavors are seldom hampered by a surfeit of healers.
Good point. Allow me to offer my services as well. I have spent quite enough time here of late, so I'll be coming. But we will need someone to keep an eye on things. I trust you have no objections?
None, my lady. Gladly shall I continue to serve as caretaker of the Waking Sands, and there keep watch for signs of Primal and Ascian activity both.
As capable as my learned friend undoubtedly is, there are some troubles that may prove too much for a single Scion, on account of which I mean to stay.
It is settled then.
Let us each see to our preparations. Ready, my friend? Well then, Tataru, I leave the Rising Stones in your capable hands.
Don't worry, Alphino. I'll see that the place is still standing when you come back.
Mistress Yshtola has unfolded all. You are bound for Girabania?
Aye. The Alliance would have us make contact with the Alamegan resistance as soon as possible.
It begins then. As soon it shall in Doma, if the gods are good. 'Tis but a pity it must be now. I am sorry that we shall not be present to fight beside you in the battles to come.
You have stood with us countless times, Lady Yugiri. Pray do not apologize.
Then let us thank you instead. You and yours stood with us from the first, when we came to this land as refugees in search of sanctuary. Loath am I to think what might have become of my people, had you not extended to us the hand of friendship. We will never forget. This I solemnly swear.
Much has changed since first you set foot on these shores. Revenant's Toll stands as a testament to that. I'm sure your people will manage in your absence.
Indeed. They have built a new home for themselves and no longer need me to shepherd them. The time has come for Kozetsu and I to return to our master, to our home.
I know how you feel. It's time I went home, too.
Though our battlefields be 1,000 miles apart, our purpose is one. That all men hearken to the clarion call of freedom, of liberation, from Eorzea to the Far East, that they may rise up and cast down the curse of Garlemald.
Take care, you hear me? When all of this is over, we're going to celebrate, together. Just you wait.
I should like that very much. Fare you well.
I remember crossing the border, standing in Girabania once more. Me and my fellow Scions, the Warrior of Light among us. Behind us, Baelsar's wall cutting the land in two. Freedom on one side, tyranny on the other. Tyranny and the promise of a new beginning. But one that could only be bought with flames and blood. I remember the old stories. How the Breaker of Worlds came down from on high and cleft the earth with a single blow. Ralga's Reach, a holy place and a fitting home for the Resistance, for the brave and the true, the loyal sons and daughters of Alamigo. They were waiting for us there, men and women whose souls still cried out for what was lost, for what could be ours again.
Allow me to welcome you once more to Ralga's Reach, our humble headquarters. My name is Conrad Kemp, and I have the dubious honor of overseeing operations here.
It is a pleasure to meet you, Master Kemp. I am Alfino Leveilleur of the Scions of the Seventh Dawn, as are my comrades. Before I speak of our purpose here, pray allow me to thank you for sheltering Ida, forgive me, Lys, and Papalimo at great risk to yourselves.
No, there's no need for that. They risk their necks for us enough times. It was the least we could do.
I wanted to, about the mask and...
Don't fret over that. You're not the first person to take up arms against the Empire under a false name. We'd do the same if we had any sense. My condolences for your loss, John.
Papalimo laid down his life to save us. To give us a chance to make a better future for ourselves. There will never be a better time to drive the Garlians from our lands. But we have to take the lead on this. We can't leave it to fanatics like Ilbert.
More than a few of our people were taken in by his promises. Followed him all the way to the wall. Good men and women who never came back. When Monago told us what had happened, how the bastard had made sacrifices of them for his twisted ritual. By Rolger, it filled me with an unholy fury. But what's done is done. Best we can do now is see that it wasn't all in vain.
That is why we are here today, sir. To see that some good comes of this tragedy. On behalf of the Eorzean Alliance, we do hereby extend a formal offer of military assistance to the Alamegan resistance.
Do you now? Well, go on then. I'm sure there's more to it than that. So that's the way of it, eh? The Alliance, hoping to avoid a direct confrontation with the superior forces of the Empire, wishes to engage them by proxy with our vastly inferior ones. My comrades and I must confer on your proposal. A moment, if you please.
Of course, Master Kemp. Take all the time you require.
Thank you. Thank you all for waiting. We have reached a consensus. I, Conrad Kemp, do hereby accept the Eorzean Alliance's proposal. You must understand, however, that our cooperation comes with certain caveats.
Those caveats being...
I take no joy in this, just so you know. Were it within my power, I'd offer you more assistance. But the resistance is far more fragmented than you realize. The men and women in my care belong to but one of many factions. Simply put, I can only speak for the people of Rolga's Reach. Now, I have every intention of appealing to the others, and I expect many will agree, but it will take time, and I cannot guarantee universal support.
Understood. I shall see that the Alliance is under no misapprehensions as to your position.
Much obliged. But that's not the whole of it. As you can imagine, the loss of those who cast their lot with the Griffin left us short on numbers. Some of our most trusted veterans died at the wall, and we've had to fill their posts with the young and inexperienced. Frankly, everything's in a right bloody mess.
Oh, we'd be more than happy to help you get back on your feet. If we're going to work together, we'll be doing ourselves a favor.
Well, there's no shortage of work to be done, that's for sure. We're in dire need of new blood, too.
Ishtola and I could lend a hand in the infirmary. From what I saw, they could do with a few more healers.
Very well. I, for my part, shall return to the Rising Stones. I'm certain there are others among the Scions who would welcome the opportunity to fight for Alamegan liberation.
Is there anything else we can do to help?
I had something else in mind for you lot. Monago and Mefrid will tell you more.
Understood. We won't let you down.